Which framework is based on the principle of contextual integrity? A. NIST, B. OECD, C. FAIR, D. Nissenbaum's contextual integrity. Correct answer. D. Nissenbaum's contextual integrity. What is the primary goal of privacy by design? A. Ensuring compliance with global privacy laws. B. Enhancing user interface design. C. Embedding privacy into the design of IT systems and business practices. D. Maximizing data collection while maintaining user trust. Correct answer. C. Embedding privacy into the design of IT systems and business practices. During the data lifecycle, when does anonymization typically occur? A. Collection. B. Use. C. Retention. D. Destruction. Correct answer. C. Retention. What is the primary responsibility of a privacy technologist in an organization? A. Legal advice on privacy laws. B. Development of marketing strategies. C. Implementation of technical privacy measures. D. Human resources management. Correct answer. C. Implementation of technical privacy measures. Which of the following is a key ethical concern during data collection? A. Encryption effectiveness. B. Bias and discrimination. C. Cloud storage selection. D. Software versioning practices. Correct answer. B. Bias and discrimination. In the context of data use, what does the term secondary use refer to? A. Using data for the purpose for which it was originally collected. B. Unauthorized access to stored data. C. Using collected data for a purpose other than the one specified at collection. D. Archiving data for historical research. Correct answer. C. Using collected data for a purpose other than the one specified at collection. Which strategy is not considered a data-oriented strategy for privacy enhancement? A. Abstract. B. Minimize. C. Pseudonymization. D. Hide. Correct answer. C. Pseudonymization. What is a primary objective of privacy engineering within an organization? A. Enhancing corporate profitability. B. Predictability in privacy outcomes. C. Reducing employee turnover. D. Maximizing data collection. Correct answer. B. Predictability in privacy outcomes in privacy by design methodology. What is the significance of documenting requirements? A. Outlining budgetary constraints. B. Specifying technical specifications for IT equipment. C. Establishing privacy objectives and how they will be achieved. D. Detailing the organizational chart. Correct answer. C. Establishing privacy objectives and how they will be achieved. Which emerging technology poses significant challenges to privacy due to its ability to collect massive amounts of personal data? A. Quantum computing. B. Blockchain. C. Internet of Things, IoT. D. Non-fungible tokens, NFTs. Correct answer. C. Internet of Things, IoT. What is a fundamental difference between de-identification and anonymization? A. De-identification is reversible, whereas anonymization is not. B. Anonymization is a form of encryption, while de-identification is not. C. De-identification is a newer technology than anonymization. D. Anonymization requires consent, but de-identification does not. Correct answer. A. De-identification is reversible, whereas anonymization is not. Which principle is crucial for managing privacy risks in software development? A. Continuous integration. B. Disassociability. C. Agile methodology. D. Waterfall process. Correct answer. B. Disassociability. How does value-sensitive design contribute to privacy? A. It prioritizes financial benefits over user privacy. B. It integrates human values into the design process. C. It ensures the highest possible data collection efficiency. D. It focuses exclusively on legal compliance. Correct answer. B. It integrates human values into the design process. In the context of privacy by design, what role does visibility and transparency play? A. Ensuring that data processing activities are hidden from users. B. Allowing users to see and verify how the data is used. C. Making the privacy policy less visible to discourage reading. D. Reducing the amount of data collected from users without their knowledge. Correct answer. B. Allowing users to see and verify how the data is used. What does the term dark patterns refer to in privacy design? A. Efficient data processing algorithms. B. User interface designs that trick users into giving away more information than intended. C. Security measures to protect data in transit. D. legal strategies to navigate around privacy laws. Correct answer B. User interface designs that trick users into giving away more information than intended, and D. Legal strategies to navigate around privacy laws. Which of the following best defines the principle of privacy by default? A. Users must opt into any setting that is not privacy protected. B. The highest privacy settings are applied by default without any user input required. C. Privacy settings can only be changed by the service provider. D. User data is collected by default, with the option to opt out. Correct answer. B. The highest privacy settings are applied by default without any user input required. The concept of full life cycle protection emphasizes A. Data protection from collection to destruction. B. Continuous protection throughout the data's use in the organization. C. Long-term storage of data with periodic access control verification. D. Ensuring data protection only during the active use phase. Correct answer. A. Data protection from collection to destruction. In the context of privacy engineering, manageability refers to A. The ability to process data at scale. B. The ease of implementing privacy controls. C. The capability to oversee and adjust privacy settings as needed. D. The effort required to develop privacy-enhancing technologies. Correct answer. C. The capability to oversee and adjust privacy settings as needed. Which emerging technology has the most significant potential to revolutionize data privacy through decentralized processing? A. Edge computing. B. Quantum computing. C. Artificial intelligence. D. Blockchain. Correct answer. A. Edge computing. The key challenge in privacy with wearable devices is A. The computational power required for data processing. B. The potential for constant surveillance and data collection. C. The user's ability to control the device settings. D. Ensuring device interoperability within existing networks. Correct answer. B. The potential for constant surveillance and data collection. Which aspect of e-commerce is most directly related to privacy concerns? A. The use of chatbots for customer service. B. Online, mobile payment systems. C. Alerts and notifications for sales. D. Ad tech and targeted advertising. Correct answer. D. Ad tech and targeted advertising. A primary privacy concern with biometric data is A. Its inability to uniquely identify individuals. B. The ease of changing biometric data if compromised. C. Its high error rate in identification processes. D. The sensitivity and irrevocability of the data. Correct answer. D. The sensitivity and irrevocability of the data. Privacy challenges with remote working primarily involve A. Finding suitable work-life balance. B. Ensuring secure access to corporate networks. C. Managing team communication effectively. D. Providing ergonomic workplace solutions. Correct answer. B. Ensuring secure access to corporate networks.